In my quest to find Ellie and Al a mortgage-free home in rural Aberdeenshire, we've taken the high road.
I see a lot of potential with this one.
Okay.
And the low road, to three very different properties, trying to find the perfect balance between the ideal family house and the right amount of land. But so far, there's been no pleasing everyone.
So this is it, the last crack of the whip.
I like it.
Yeah.
It sits in the landscape nicely.
Al, what are you thinking?
Yeah, I'm liking it so far. Yeah.
It's not as grand and as as the schoolhouse.
Mm.
But it is a very cosy, warm, comfortable, lovely family home. So should we get inside and have a look?
Sounds good.
Liking it works for me. I can't wait to show them both what's to come. This 5-bed detached property is on the market for offers over £370,000. If the last house they saw was too grand for Al, I'm hoping the 5 bedrooms and stylish but practical reception rooms here will be much more to his taste.
Come and stand here.
Oh, wow.
So this is formal dining area.
Mm.
Grown-up living room.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But not... Because I know for you, with the wow room, it was too wow, wasn't it? It was too big.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a bit.
Too imposing.
What are you thinking about this one?
I like this one more.
Mm.
More? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Why?
All my heating energy is not going up to the roof.
You're so practical.
I think the wow room in the old schoolhouse, it didn't necessarily feel like our type of living space.
Right. So I get it. This is much more you. It feels more you.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Anyway, let's go and look at the kitchen, because I think you're going to love the kitchen. Mm. You lead the way.
Okay.
What do you think?
I want this kitchen.
Interesting. What do you like about it?
I think, again, the height of the ceiling doesn't make me feel like I'm getting lost and everything's mm-hmm. going up there and creating noise.
Yeah. Is this more to your taste and your idea of what you had in your head before you moved up here?
Yes.
Interesting.
I think it is. Yes.
Mm-hmm. I know boot rooms and where to put all the various stuff is quite important. That's just through that door. Go and pop your heads in there and have a little look and see what you think.
Oh, okay. Utility space.
It's really warm.
Boot and muddy space. I could see that being the dog corner.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, this is all right, isn't it? You really start getting tomatoes and things going up along here.
This would be brilliant, definitely. This is it. Even the cat prefers it in here.
I think I might have finally cracked it. Don't want to put all my eggs in one basket, but I haven't seen Al this excited in any of the other properties.
Al's dreams of growing your own are looking up. And as plants aren't the only things that could be growing up here, I want to show them how the house could really work for their other little flowers.
This is a nice room.
This is a cracking room, isn't it?
So this room is known as the Ark, hence the Noah's Ark there.
Yes.
And listen, obviously, there's hailstones coming down at the moment.
Nice.
As we can see, but it still feels like it's exciting! This could make a brilliant den for the kids. With telescope, with games, they can have sleepovers here.
Yes.
It's ideal for that, isn't it, really?
It really is.
Hmm.
And now for the plot twist, or the lack of one.
It's about 1/2 acre.
Okay.
But over there, you've got 230 acres of country park, so there's a lot to be getting on with, and you don't have to mow that lawn.
True.
Lots and lots of space to explore. I'm basically going to stay up here, get a cup of tea, light the fire, and have a little nap.
Excellent, good plan.
That's a perfect place for a nap. Out you go, my lovelies. I'll see you in a minute.
Well, I've definitely earned a rest. It's been a journey to get to this point, but I think I may have finally struck gold.
Wow. This is a master bedroom, isn't it?
Yeah, this is all right.
Yeah.
I really like the downstairs. I really like the upstairs.
Well, that's a turn up for the books, isn't it? Because Al is more animated about this house than Ellie. But I think that they could both imagine themselves here. I might have just cracked it.
This is a nice house. It feels more like a home.
But is it enough like a home for them to leave their mortgage behind and move 500 miles? I want to try and ease any doubts Al may still have.
Sorry, we got distracted by the kitchen.
I'm surprised you've even been able to draw yourself away from that kitchen. It is lovely, isn't it?
Definitely.
Right, let me tell you a couple of things about the land.
Mm-hmm.
That little gate that you've spotted there leads up to a forest woodland walk.
Lovely.
And then you've got the country park with 230 acres, almost directly opposite.
Excellent.
Even though this is the smallest plot, you've got all of that on your doorstep.
Mm.
So that's the balance, isn't it? That's the compromise.
You've given us things to think about outside of the boxes which we created for ourselves.
Right. It's opened your eyes, hasn't it?
It has.
I think what we need to get our heads around is the fact that this is real and the wish list and the idea that we've got isn't what we're looking for.
Tailoring ambitions, I guess.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. We need to find somewhere where we can do a spreadsheet.
Yes,
please. I also need to find somewhere that's a bit warmer than this because my kneecaps are now shaking because I'm so cold and I'm not dressed for the Scottish weather. Shall we retire?
Let us retire.
And have a little think about what we're going to do. After you guys. Well, this has been an adventure, hasn't it?
It has.
It's been interesting.
Despite its impressive plot, the first property small upstairs made it an instant no for Ellie and Al. And the exterior of the second house lost them from the get-go. It was the third property, the old schoolhouse, brimming with features and character, where things got interesting. For Ellie, it felt like love at first sight.
Look at this, Al.
But its high ceilings and grand interior didn't do it for Al.
You, Al, seemed a little bit daunted.
It was that far outside of what my thought process had been for a family home.
Mm.
It was taking some significant adjustment
yeah.
to be able to visualise us in that environment.
Yeah.
So with the old schoolhouse feeling a little grand for Al's homestead dreams, I needed to find them a family house that would have the warmth and vibe Ellie craves and still deliver enough outdoor allure to excite Al. Enter our last property, with its lovely family rooms and homely farmhouse kitchen, and its perfect walk-in greenhouse, surrounded by incredible countryside and on the market for offers over £370,000.
I sensed a seismic shift, actually, particularly in you, Al, when we went into that. I kept seeing you stroking the worktops.
It was definitely more of a house where we could see ourselves
yeah.
and we could see ourselves being at home and at ease.
And the irony with that one is that had the smallest plot of land, but you didn't really seem that bothered by it. It didn't come up in conversation.
No, I was quite struck. I was really struck with the house. And looking at the land, I think that the fact that you got that woodland so close, it wouldn't completely counter the lack of the land with it, but it would go a really good way towards that.
Yeah.
Mm.
So after seeing the reality of what they can buy, I just need to check.
Are you prepared to go mortgage free?
Yes.
Without a doubt.
Oh, that was quick. So you're convinced that this is the way forward, you're going to do it?
Absolutely. To have all that and the extra cash in the pocket?
Yeah.
It's a no-brainer, really.
Out of the four houses that we've looked at, was there a clear favourite?
As far as a house goes, the lovely farm family kitchen
yeah.
was the front runner.
Yeah, without a doubt.